Hello, Saturday of the Octave 2020. Father Dennis with a word of encouragement. What am I bringing to your attention? How the truth is unstoppable. What does that mean? I have an example of what lies can do. I remember when we were young, seeing sugar was a great temptation, and I don't know why all parents fought that. So this one day, we were left at home, and me and my siblings, we went to the kitchen and found the container of sugar at our reach. You know, it started everyone taking a little bit, running to hide, licking it, coming back. So at the moment, we realized that we have emptied a container, which I presume it was almost more than half a kg. But all was leaked, gone. We were there now, knowing nothing will be known. Only just after a few minutes, we had mom coming. It was time for lunch. She is coming to prepare for us lunch. Attention was brought into our kitchen. Everything was scattered up and down. So she started arranging them as she prepared for lunch. What she came up to, it was this container of sugar, very dirty, and she picked it up, called us. When we came, we saw her holding the container in her hand. I trust we looked at each other, saying nothing. So, also being in that state of saying nothing, Mom sent me to bring the mirror. I rushed to our room to bring our mirror with the mind set that mom is going to make her hair, as usual, when she asked for a mirror, only to ask me to look into the mirror. I looked, and what I saw, I don't know. I don't know why today it is very easy for anyone to choose to hold to lies. Today we hear of Peter and John going around. Now they are facing the Sanhedrin. They are into judgment. They are being questioned of what they have done and what they are continuing to do. The Sanhedrin is asking, what should we do with this man? Because everyone in Jerusalem is believing in what they are saying. As they kept warning them, the more the word kept spreading. What had corrupted this system of justice that they could not see the truth that was being spread all the world? But look what Christ did. He comes to the 11 now. He appears to them. And what does he insist? That they need to believe what is said and what now they have seen. They should go all over the world to preach the good news. That was a challenge. That was an inspiration. They were ready. They were inspired. They were fueled to go to spread the good news. He is risen. He is the light of the world. There is nothing that has power over human again. No sin that can keep us captives. He has set us free. If only we believe in him, if only we ask for forgiveness and be ready to grow into believing him. I remember very well the lesson taught by my mother. When she asked me to look into the mirror, what did I see? I saw what she saw. The truth was just there. I grew knowing that the mirror reported me to my mother. What is your experience? I want to wish you the very best as you make this choice what to believe in. May you keep safe, you and your family. May God bless you. I love you. Take care.